Okay, starting over. Hey everyone, Wanderbot here, and welcome back to freaking Roguelands. Okay, so we're going to be playing as Wander, the Lancer, which is probably going to be a bit of a mess. Hip. Oh, yeah. Oh, crap. Hip. This has gone wrong. And oh, wait, that actually did a lot of damage. Okay. Hip. Bah! Okay! Okay, we managed to survive, just barely. Unfortunately, we're right in the death zone. Yeah, lances suck in this game. But I just killed myself. I really wish the lances, okay. I really wish the lances didn't harm you when you did your charge forward. It's kind of a shame, yeah, when you attack, move backwards. Yeah, I feel like I should have invincibility when I'm attacking forwards. Otherwise, okay, let's not grab the Doom Guard. I haven't crafted that yet. Can I place that there? Yes, I can. What are you talking about? Alright, now I got a sword. Cool. So let's go back out there with actual weaponry this time around. I could bring, like, a lot of equipment with me if I really wanted to, because I've actually been farming this game solo and co-op on another character just to, you know, get a general feel for it. Unfortunately, that general feel has hurt my impressions a little bit of the game, just because there's actually a lot less content here than you think there would be. That said, it's pretty fun, and I'm looking forward to later patches. And I don't know. It's a lot prettier than Magicite, somehow. It feels like almost vector pixels instead, which doesn't make any sense, but still. Okay, come here. We got death on the line. Yours, specifically. Okay, and we don't have any particularly obnoxious rocks along the way either. Which makes my life easier. Okay. And of course, as usual, murder all innocent wildlife. Because you need their eyeballs. I mean, it's World of Warcraft logic. Except for in this case, eyeballs turn into swords and shields and stuff. I'm not really sure about the logic there, but it makes sense. Yeah, Magicite was very dark with, like, boring colors and stuff like that. Yeah, absolutely. And I'm totally okay. I'm okay with this. I mentioned this at the beginning of co-op, but, you know, at first I was annoyed that Magicite got dumped and, you know, turned into early access hell forever. At the same time, I'm glad that happened, because this does feel so much better. So let's avoid pissing off any worms for a bit. We got some gear to get first, before I'm ready to fight too many worms. Or Helcom. Useful. Though, not the greatest. Let's stay away from these rocks. Okay. Is it coming? Good. I didn't have to back up into a worm to avoid damage. Because I can probably fight most worms. So we'll see how that goes. Do we got anything up here? Nope. Well, okay, we got friends. Ah, we found the exit. We've also found a lot of rocks. Alright, speed up. I wish the swiftness also increased my attack speed. Or something, I don't know. I can't wait until I can get more, like, chips. But I've yet to figure out where to get them, which is kind of a shame. I would like to get more. Should have been free for people that already owned Magicite. I feel like it should have had, like, a 33% off discount and stuff like that. So you don't like that you have to go into a separate combat mode. See? Ah! Oh! Okay! Yeah! Let's get over here. Alright. Let's do this. So honestly, I don't mind the fact that this game is separated into combat mode and not. I feel like the combat mode is... I don't like the fact that it zooms in exactly, but it feels okay. Like, it could have been executed a lot worse. Like pressing a separate key on the keyboard or something like that. But it doesn't work that way. It's actually fairly... It's a fairly smooth transition. And this does free up a lot of interface space. Because I can have, like, a bunch of consumable items up here. To make some pretty nice things. There we go. I was looking for one of these. Okay, how much HP do I have? 4. I'd like to get back for a health kit at some point. Now, I know I've got a rock coming down on my head pretty soon, but I'm still gonna try and gather a little bit more before we leave. Let's see, you need to craft health packs, by the way. No! I don't like falling too much in this game. You never know what's below you. Like, I don't like how the camera doesn't follow you directly. In fact, I feel like when falling, the camera should look down. Instead, Because it annoys me a little bit that it's like you can't... The phrase look out below literally is not possible. Okay. We're safe. Let's not get crushed by rocks. And we're good to go. Okay. Hit this thing. Got 3 health left. That'll be fine. Nope. Don't want to be there. That place is full of broken dreams. Okay, and we've got plenty of mana. So we've got plenty of speed. There we go. Yeah, avoiding the rocks at first was kind of frustrating. Now I'm just used to it, and it actually feels pretty good once you get used to it along the way. Okay, well, let's go back to the Desolate Canyon, but really we're not actually going to be doing a whole lot of things. Okay, Eyeball Emblem. Yeah, I'll buy that. Need those. Don't need health kit. In fact, I don't really have much else here, except for we're going to murder the local populace for free experience and money. Because those things are useful. Okay. Wasn't there a word of Splunky too? Huh, that'd be cool. God, we should see if we can get the... I should see if I can get the Splunky online co-op mod working at some point. That could actually be a lot of fun. Okay, and we have nothing here. And we're very poor and very injured. So, let's go back. Okay, so first and foremost, we need to build... We need to go in here. None of these are particularly useful, so let's just buy a bunch of health kits. Use up all of my resources, because, I mean, I'm never gonna not need health kits. Then let's take a look at equipment, see if I can get anything useful. I can pull out some items that I already own, but I find that kind of breaks the sequence of the game really fast, using, like, higher tier equipment, so I'm gonna avoid doing so. I'm just gonna throw my various arms and equipment in here, and I think we're good. I'm just gonna carry the Aether Lance with me, because if I drop it, who cares? It's bad anyway. Okay. Now let's heal up. I really wish there was, like, a healing station in this game, that you paid, like, a nominal fee to, because it feels kind of dumb that I have to spend, you know, generally obnoxious to get items, just to get, you know, myself back up to full health. It's not the end of the world, but still. Okay, so unfortunately, welcome to the small grinding section of the game. I guess it's not so bad, because realistically, as soon as I can make a gun, which should be at the end of this one, things speed up a lot. And then once we get some armor, we get some damage boosts. And things actually get a lot easier, too. Okay. Yeah. Yeah. Got him. Alright, perfect. What are the world fragments for? Hell if I know. Really wish I did know. I'm hoping that they're involved in, weapon upgrades. Because currently, as far as I can tell, there's no way to level your weapons, even though, if you check your inventory, Aether Blade level 1. It looks to be built into the game. So, my bet is world fragments are specifically either for two things. One, giving you access to biomes. Two, either giving you access to biomes, or two, upgrading your stuff. My hope is for... Uh-oh. My hope is it's used for upgrading items. Just because I would like to be able to upgrade my items with generally low personal cost. Okay. But, I don't know. We'll figure it out. I don't think it's in the game yet. Currently, I have access to... don't want to be there. I'd like to get those credits, but... They're now largely not attainable. Nope, there we go. Okay, good. And monster eyeballs. In fact, I'd rather have monster eyeballs than credits, because credits are kind of a dime a dozen. Monster eyeballs aren't terrible, aren't that hard to pick up, but does get a little bit obnoxious. Okay. You're going down. Oh, wait, no. Never mind. He's dead. Okay, but yeah, I really wish the camera was a little bit more sensible for falling down. That is a big, major fix that I hope Sean throws into the game. And luckily, I think Sean might actually be watching some of these videos. He watched... My voice is cracking a bit. Because he commented on the first one, thanking me for my critique. And I'm like, yay! You know, maybe this one gets finished. Yeah. Okay. Could probably use some speed here. We need maneuverability? Nope, never mind. This is easy enough. And perfect. Okay. But one way or another, I'm looking forward to what gets added to this game, because it's got a nice base. The music gets a little bit repetitive. Originally, I liked the music, but it definitely, the lack of variety is starting to hurt it a little bit. But, I mean, what can you do? This is a solo developer project. With maybe a little bit of musical help and visual help. I have no idea, actually. I should probably look into that at some point. Okay. But yeah, I'm trying to grab as much stone, herbs, and experience as I can. Because we're gonna need the levels eventually, and I'd like this character to survive. You ain't coming to my turf. This is my turf. This is my zone. Auto zone. I don't know why it's auto zone. And we got more friends. Hello. Keep away. Keep away because I'm in danger. Okay. Let's scoot around. Let's grab these bits. Okay. Think we're good to go. Might as well grab the experience. You can also grab, you can actually get multiple drones. So, if I have the resources for it, I'm actually gonna make several. Because it makes gathering so much faster. Once we've gotten to a certain point, then gathering isn't as necessary. Can I get in this one? No, I've already gotten it. Okay. I think we're good to leave, so let's do so. Has the Disgaea finale happened yet? Nope, that's going to be later tonight. That is actually going to be after multiplayer stuff ends. That was kind of a risky situation. We're good, though. I got plenty of health kits, so it's not like I'm in extreme danger at any point in time. But still. Okay, come on. I like the weapon design in this game. I'm a huge fan of the Phantasy Star Online, Phantasy Star Universe, Phantasy Star whatever nonsense. I loved playing them when I was younger, and the idea of, like, sci-fantasy is always kind of attractive to me. Just because, you know, I would rather be running around with a giant laser sword and beam rifle than a bow and arrow and just, like, a steel sword. Okay. Let's keep going. Oh, my credit! My credits! There we go. Is there ever a quick heal button? I hope there is. Alright, let's go to the Hollow Cavern. I might be able to survive like this, come to think of it. Do I have a better Aether Blade? No. I could pull out the Doom Guard. Yeah, let's pull out the Doom Guard. Let's make this go a little bit fast. No, I haven't earned the Doom Guard. Stop being lazy, Wander. Alright, let's dump off all of our random junk that we don't need. Oh, Monster Tooth doesn't fit. Oh, that's because I'm depositing resources into a tab that shouldn't be deposited into. I also realized all of my tokens are out of sorts. Because I have the second page of my bank for tokens. Okay, there we go. Now we can dump all of our random junk. Perfect. I'm going to be able to do some crafting on the next stage. Probably. There we go. Anything else I missed? Doesn't look like it. Okay, cool. Let's move on. This area is not actually too hard. It's actually a little bit easier, in certain ways. Also, there are these guys. They don't make nice noises when you kill them. Or hit them. They don't make noises when you kill them. I may or may not be a little bit sociopathic with this. However, resources are resources, and I need my resources. I was expecting I'd get attacked by something. Nope! These guys do not summon the Great Protector or any such thing. They just take it. They take it like champions, and then explode into free resources for me. Come back here, you are not escaping. Okay, so let's go back for a little bit of money. I've got an Orhelcum emblem and a Shroom emblem, both of which are fairly good prices and useful as well. Okay. Let's see, there might never be a quick heal button. So, I don't know if there's ever going to be a quick heal button, but there are more advanced health packs for the more health you have. Like, right here is the health pack 2, which restores 5 HP, which makes it go a little bit faster. That said, it, you know, costs more resources, so it's a bit of a trade-off. I'm going to actually see if I can discover some of those, seeing as I'm coming to this area. And I'm going to be getting shrooms and monster claws and stuff. Okay. You'll now add a great protector to fuck you up. You know what? If that's the case, I'm okay with it. Like, in the original game, in town, if you killed a chicken, if you killed a certain number of chickens, a chicken boss would show up and wreck your day. It was actually pretty easy. Okay, can I explain how this game works in terms of keys? It's actually keyboard and mouse. So, I'm currently moving with, WASD, so A and D left and right, W and S do nothing, and then I've got Q and E for dashes. I can also press spacebar to jump, and I can jump as much as one. Right click pulls me into, combat mode, and left click attacks, but only in combat mode, otherwise it's useless. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, and 6, correspond with, you know, the bars up top. So when you're outside of combat mode, you can use various things like the health kits or your drone. So 1 will send my drone somewhere, 2 will use a health kit, and, you know, 3 through 6 are useless right now. And when I'm in combat, I can press 1 to do, like, a combat chip, which is my, like, battle boost. Yep, ow, ow, ooh, those things hurt a lot. Alright, let's go around the top. Oh, hey, there's some more health in anyway. Perfect. Okay, we want to go around this thing. This is a tense little area, but we get some decent tier 2 equipment, so that's not a bad deal. Okay, I'll come back to that in a second when it's significantly less dangerous. Perfect. Okay, and then, yeah, so you use 1 through 6 in combat to use your battle abilities. And that's pretty much how this game works, actually. It's fairly simple. The controls are a little bit awkward just because WASD is not exactly the easiest, but it more or less plays like Terraria with minor differences. Okay, what kind of stuff are we getting? Oh, hey, finally an enemy! I've been waiting for one of these dudes to show up. Ah, crap! Interestingly enough, these bugs back up from... they back up. You hit them, they don't knock away from you. They back up. It's weird. I don't like it that much, actually. Okay. Back your ass up. I ain't got time for you people. Oh boy. Luckily these things are worth more experience. I'm not entirely prepared for the inevitable assault upon my person here. Okay. The rocks are bit mean. Okay. Hey, I do enough damage to murder people now. In one shot. How do you get more battle abilities? Hell if I know. I would love an answer if somebody could find that one out for me, actually. Because the combat chips, as far as I can tell, there's only one. It's probably through crafting, but I have not crafted said items yet. And... okay, good. This one does not threaten me. Ooh. Look at this, Eye of the Needle. To murder all these folks, but I am dedicated. Oh, they didn't even get a proper vocalization off. Oof. I am a monster. Is there some kind of EXP bar? Yes! I'll pull it out in a second when I'm not in danger. Back your ass up. Get out of here. Whoop. Stay away from the crazy rock thing. It's gonna murder me. And I can kill those things in 2 hits. I'm just running around with the basic equipment. Nice. So, if I press tab, you can see my EXP bar. It actually goes across the entire bottom of the screen, but eh, close enough. Okay, let's just stay away for a second. Let's grab these things. Okay. Let's just stay away from these guys for a second. Whoops, that's the wrong one. Should be good to go. How come I leveled up between 6 and 18 damage? I might not have leveled... 9 and 18 damage. I might have not have leveled up fully. There we go. As far as, like, that damage goes. I don't think my damage is high enough. Nope, it's not. So chances are, when I did more than 9 damage, it's, a result of a crit. Because you can crit in this game. Okay. So let's go back. It's time to leave. There's nothing else here. It could also be 10 damage. That is also absolutely possible, but I've crit things before. So, there are multiple possibilities here. I do not know. I'm looking for... Aha! Hello! Okay, I'm looking forward to... Oh, hey! I haven't actually been up here yet. And those rock clusters, every once in a while summon a thing. Yeah, it's 10 damage. It just looks like 18. Because the way this game writes zeros is a bit weird. Okay. So we're getting the resources we need. Just stay away from the danger. I do wish there was more, like, monster variety in this game. I mean, currently there's just the bug things, which is... I'm okay with the bug things, but they do... They don't threaten you that much, so it actually makes this area, the deep cavern, particularly easy. If you're trying to farm for, you know, basic gear and equipment. Okay, there's nothing particularly good here, but we're going to go make some equipment. First, let's loot the area and murder the general residents. Hello, sir. How do you feel about death? Not good things, apparently. Well, I'm sorry. Not sorry. Okay, yeah, that's a cheap beetle emblem. Not a happy day. Perfect. Okay, so let's scoot our butt this way. Also, when you're dodging, you will dodge farther in the direction that you're pointing. So if I'm trying to dodge backwards, I sometimes will dodge backwards for less time. It's a bit weird, and I'm not entirely sure how it works. Okay, well, let's go back to base. Let's actually make some equipment here. I've got plenty of HP kits for the time being. So, let's make some nonsense. Oh, you know what? Let's see. Do I have any tier 2 stuff? Emblems must be of the same tier. Oh. Well, that's not useful. Do I not have... There's got to be another tier 2 resource here. I'm just going to grab all this stuff. We're going to see what I can craft with this. Some of these have got to be good. Useful, I mean. Okay. Because I'd like to figure out how to make the tier 2. I wish there was an inventory sort button. Oh, it's probably the beetle. Isn't it? That's the other tier 2 resource. Because, yeah, I've currently... Oh, wait, yeah, dung beetle. Mushroom. And monster claw. Okay. Nothing. Damn. Okay, I've made anti-poison. I've switched those around. Energy pack. Okay. So we've tried both claws. So what else did we try? Okay, so we want to do mushroom first. Yeah, I should probably take that out. Hey, health back 1. That's not what I needed. Health mana pack 5. Okay, so these are all useless. Blue blocks are tier 2. Yes, but you can't use them in making HP kits. The blue ghost beetle. Blue ghost beetle is tier 3. Ah, I could try some tier 3 alchemy. Ooh, that's a bit wasteful. Whatever, we'll do it. Plant and... Nope, that's Galactic Cadet. Which isn't what we're looking for. Do I not have another tier 3 resource here? Nope, doesn't look like it. Ah, nuts. Oh yeah, there it is. Chitin fragment. Anti-frost. Okay, so we've tried beetle first. Let's try seed first. Ah, that's how you make the big HP kits. Are these going into my inventory? Oh, they just... No, they just get deleted. Holy crap, so if you do alchemy and you don't actually, if you do the alchemy stuff and you don't actually take it out, it just gets deleted from your inventory. That sucks a bit. Okay, well, whatever, we've learned things. So now I've got all the alchemy recipes, so I can just gather stuff. It didn't used to do that, so I assumed that he had patched it in a different manner. Nope. Alright, let's just... Tokenetize everything that we can tokenetize. Monster eyeballs. Where's the butterfly? Oh, wait. I've already butterflied. Okay, cool. So, let's see. I actually have no idea if I've tried every combo here. I feel like I haven't, but I don't know. Can you make a token of the dust? Nope. Not at all. So what do we want to make? Do we want to make a gun? Yeah, let's make a gun. I've already got the recipe for it. Let's see, is it any good? Yeah, that's a good one. Arc fire. Okay, then let's see. I'm gonna make my like basic equipment needed first, and then we'll make other things. We'll do weird science. Problem is, there's no way of like telling if you've already made a thing before, or not. So it feels kind of wasteful. I'll get a second drone. Okay. Oh shoot, I need a shield. Okay, so we've made those things. Now let's science. Beetle. Eye. Herb. Okay, we just made one of those. See, it doesn't work with gear, it just works with alchemy, weirdly enough. I should probably just get rid of that Aether Lance. It's not going to do anybody any good. Same thing with that Aether Bips. I've learned nothing. Well, this is great. Okay, so any of these actually good? Nope. Off into space with you. Actually, I'll keep the spare swords. Just because the spare swords are good. I'll keep one of them. You also go to space. Bye. Don't care. My inventory is filling up pretty bad. Oh, shoot. I had more stuff here. Well, science. Do I not have any more butterfly tokens? I do not. Okay, never mind. Less science. Goodbye. I thought I had more butterflies. Turns out the answer is a very, very solid no. That's fair. So let's get rid of things. Let's get out of here. Oh, we should probably make a better sword, too, come to think of it. Yeah, because that's Thunderworm emblems. Or Helcom, Beetle, Shroom. Actually, come to think of it, we've got Claw, we've got Beetle, we've got Mushroom. We got Orihelcom. I might as well make some more things, see what they do. Science! Okay, so let's do Orihelcom. Okay, that makes Aegis. Let's switch them. That makes a Titan Helm, which I think is good for magic. Okay, switch these around. Cadet Uniform. Beast Claw. Waltz Thunder, and that's all the resources I can shove in here. That's it! We got some new cool stuff. So let's see. So we've got... Oh, we already have a Waltz Thunder. Okay, well that's fine. It's probably better than the generic Mage's Gauntlet, so let's get that out of there. To space with you! You useless thing. Wait, no. Titan Helm's good for mages. What's this good for? Oh, wait, no. That's good for faith. Weird. Okay, well, I don't even know what my current equipment is good for. Actually, my current equipment is perfect for what I'm doing. I'm running low on water. Wow, yeah, this is also kind of a worthless item. So if I die, I get to waste some of these things. I'm going to throw away this Aether Lance. At this point, I have no use for it. Oh, shoot. I've also got all these tokens in my direct inventory. Cool! So let's get out of here. What does faith do? Currently nothing. I don't know. So now we've completely retooled our character. Let's... Oh! So now we've got a bunch of portals for, like, higher level areas. So I'm gonna set my portal currently for the deep jungle. Let's do some new things. Okay. Where are the red and white stones? Health kits? Probably. I don't know. Doesn't matter. Okay. So let's... I like these enemies. They're interesting. They're not particularly threatening, but they're definitely interesting. Especially now that I have a gun, everything's gonna get a lot easier really, really fast. Especially because guns can actually shoot through surfaces and stuff. Oh yeah, I should probably heal. That's a good point. I've not been paying full attention to that business. Okay. Should probably also get some water. I think I should actually take a short break and grab a bit of water once we finish shooting that guy. I can pause, right? I hope so. You know what? Let's gather these things. And then we'll go hang out in the end. Oh, there's a monkey. That is a resilient monkey. There's no longer a monkey anymore. I can get two shot. Yeah, it's possible. I have a lot of health. Wow. How'd I get up to 30 HP? That's nuts. I'm also still playing Crawl. Yeah, well, this game's not listed on Twitch, so I don't really have much of a choice. I was probably listed as Magicite, though. Okay, now that hydration has been achieved, let's keep going. The jump is sometimes just weirdly inconsistent in this game. I don't really understand it. Okay, let's stay away from the poofy balls of death. Hello. That's dirty. Actually, let's not do too much damage to this. Nope! No, this is bad. This is a bad place to be. I got trapped there. Oh, that's, I guess, my fault. I was trying to open up the chest, and we ended up opening up the other thing. Well, let's avoid pain. And good to go. I'm glad I got the gun. More or less means I don't have to worry about melee combat, period. Which is nice. Smell some murder monkeys. From afar! I don't know, it feels colder to kill- No, I don't know. It feels colder to shoot them with a gun, that's for certain. Yep. Let's go over here. Let's get all of the resources. Because I need the spicy seeds. The basic tier 1 resources at this point are kind of useless, except for the fact that I can make a ton of health kits from them. So I guess it's not so bad. Yep. Let's keep going. Perfect. Nope, I missed. There we go. Okay. Unfortunately, we're actually hitting the, we're hitting kind of the tail end of what you can even do in Magicite. There's no tier 3 zones yet that work, as far as I know. I'm gonna test. If we see a teleporter for one pop up, then we'll be good to go. And, you know, if it actually has content in it. But, we were testing it out last night in co-op, and it was just like, well, there is nothing. And it's a shame. Okay, more portal uses. Good. As long as I can find one of those every couple of levels, every two levels preferably, then we can, mix and match it up a little bit. Okay, let's try to avoid almost certain pain. There's a lot of friends in here. Ow. Ow. Ooh, those shots do 4 damage. Good to know. Alright, well, whatever. There's only so much friendship that these guys can spit at me before problem solved. Oh, I'm killing like a weird pregnant planty looking thing with like a bug in it, and it splits out and it's just like, wah! Who are you to disturb my... Ugh. I don't know. It's a weird enemy design, that's for certain. Okay, well, let's scoot over here and do this. Okay. I want to kill that thing, but it's currently... Whoa, there's even plants up there. Strange. Okay. Are you coming? I would very much like to actually kill your individual parts here. They take a little while to go, though. I'm noticing. Alright. There we go. Close enough. And we can get the remaining cash. Do we want to get out of here? Yeah, let's get out. Get out of here. We want to find a teleporter somewhere a little bit more interesting. Even though I'm not entirely sure if there is something more interesting than that area. I have my doubts about whether or not there's actually zones past the first 3. That said, this game hasn't actually been in development for that long. So, what's currently here is not actually terribly disappointing. Let's buy an eyeball emblem at the very least. Anything else here? Don't have enough money for that. Well, I got enough of that stuff that I probably don't need to buy more. Dump it there. Dump whatever resources we got. Should probably drop the money. I've no use to hold on to it when I'm dying. Okay. Portal locks your chance at the same location? It shouldn't. If it does, I'm gonna be disappointed. Because I don't want to go to the deep jungle. I want to go elsewhere. I want to try new things. I want to see new places. I want to fight new creatures. Because, like, the visuals for a bunch of these zones exist. Like, I can go to the ancient ruins. I can go to the, I can go to, oh, shoot. What's the Norse area? The, like, frosty place. I can go to... I think there's one other. Oh yeah, the Plaguelands. But... there weren't enemies in those levels yesterday, and it was like, well, what do I do now? And the answer is, bleh. We couldn't come up with an answer yesterday, so it ultimately resulted in us, you know, quitting for the night. Which is kind of disappointing. I would actually rather there not be levels, period. And maybe it was a bug that we even had access to them. But I would rather there be, like, no levels, period, than, or, you know, the levels not available at all, if there's nothing to do with them, then have them be traversable, or, you know, you can go to them, but what's the point? And we have lost the eyeball. Alright, that's a shame. Not the end of the world, though. Whoop. Oh, okay. That was experience coming off of him. Not a big deal. Bifrost. There we go. Which is kind of weird, because there's no... whoop. There's no Heimdall there. Feels weird to have the Bifrost without the Heimdall. But maybe that's because I'm more of a Marvel nut than an actual Norse nut. I don't know much about Norse mythology, come to think of it. Ah, hello! Oh, God! I've entered in the bad place. I can get two-shot real easy here. Alright, well, let's... grab remaining... what remaining experience we have. Oops, that's the wrong one. There we go. Okay, let's just chow down on a bunch of HP... bars. It's that bastardization of Norse pronunciation. Dude! I'm an American! I don't freaking know how to speak freaking Norsian. Derf. Okay, and let's stay away from these things. Okay, lots of plants. Why would they have potions of fire resistance if there's nothing that uses fire ice? Yeah, we'll get there eventually. I think there's kind of the basis for these things, but not currently the things themselves. It's okay. We'll get there. But it does mean that this series is going to be particularly spotty in terms of, like, when videos come out, because it's going to be like, well, has anything new been added? No? Then we'll come back later. But who knows? Maybe they are in and we just ran into a bug. This is entirely possible. I do feel like this game needs kind of like an emergency beacon, so you can just like GTFO when things get hot, but it's expensive. That'd be kind of nice, because that'd be a nice way of like safeguarding your precious, precious experience. Though, I will admit, once you have the proper gear and whatever, you guys know what I mean. Once you have the proper stuff, getting back up to a high level is actually really easy, because equipment is more important than armor and the like. Okay, so why don't we stop dallying so much here? I've been enjoying picking up all the spicy seeds, but let's see. So we can go to Deep Jungle or Hollow Cavern. Let's just go to Hollow Cavern this time around. Do you lose the gear? Yes, you will lose gear, you will never lose a chip. Your chips are just automatically installed. Ah, dang. I have the bug that since there's a shop right next to the deposit chest, I can't actually drop stuff off. Okay, well, you know what? Let's murder this man. He didn't even get a... whoa, why is this one already open? What? Oh, we got a bug. Oh, that's not good. Okay. Oh, nope. Okay, this area isn't fully bugged. Well, luckily that bug is dumb. I really hope this doesn't touch me. It very much did. Okay. Oh, whatever. Yeah. Okay. Thread the needle on these. I would like that chest, though. It did not have as many cool things in it as I thought it would. Okay, let's sprint this one. Yeah, the chests are starting to break here. We're getting weird netcode issues. Or not netcode issues. We're getting weird, like, persistence issues. With the treasure chests. Which is kind of interesting. And we have a lot of friends. Let's murder these guys while the bugs decide to come my direction. Oh, since I don't have a... Since I don't have a sword... We can't knock them back in groups. That's fair. You back your butt up. Ah, dang. I wanted to get some of that stuff. Oh well. Not the end of the world. Let's just murder these guys. They give me eyeballs. I like eyeballs. I need eyeballs. I've noticed that the some of the I've been getting some of the... Oh, right. Tab isn't map in this game. That's Neurovoider. Dang it. Alright, whatever. Let's check what we've got in here. I guess it's not what we've got in here. There's nothing in these facilities apart from... I should probably grab more butterflies, come to think of it. Is there a boss for Hollow Caverns? As far as I can tell, no. I really wish there was, but there's currently no bosses in this zone. In fact, there's only one boss in the game, from what I can tell, who... I guess we should go and fight. If I can't get to a more interesting area, we're gonna go back to the ship, reset to the desolate wherever, and go fight the boss, because that's a good way to kind of end on. Okay. Is it time to leave yet? So I don't feel like fighting these guys anymore. There we go. Oh, here we go. Let's check if the deserted room actually works properly. Let's grab all of our money. We're gonna need it and drop off all of our stuff. Yeah, I got a fair amount of cash. Who knows? Okay, Ghast Emblem. Never seen that before. These are like tier 4 tokens and stuff. Which is good, because they... I mean, the resources are rare. They're not even necessarily in the game yet. Maybe you have to keep going like Magicite. I don't know. Will there be any kingdom? Probably not. I don't know. The timing would be hard, because I'm going to be doing multiplayer stuff pretty much after this. Okay, good. We can deposit. I'm going to be doing multiplayer stuff after I finish Roguelands. Whether or not Bird and Gnomes are ready, I don't know. But I'm probably going to switch over to Binding of Isaac and do a race. Can you save your character? Yes! Yes, you can save your character. There's like a hub world and stuff. Okay, yep, the ancient runes are currently broken. Music is nice, but there's nothing here. So I can loop through endlessly, but it seems like for a lot of the levels, there's nothing there yet, so they just remain empty. Which is a shame. I would rather not be given the option of going here than be given the option and then find nothing. I'll loot it for like what I can, but for the most part it's just a little bit of experience and stuff. Yeah, it's a shame. I mean, at least the environmental art is there. See, Plaguelands and Bifrost. Can't do anything here. Wasn't this the problem with Magicite? Well, with Magicite, the problem was like, it would just bug out and you couldn't get there. In this case, it's just not there. Like, you can go there, but it's not going to do you any good. Let's just spend all of our money on buying cool emblems that I can't get right now. Because, I mean, worst comes to worst, I end up with a bunch of, like, tier 3 and 4 equipment that I wouldn't be able to farm for. Which is kind of funny in its own right. Okay. Okay, let's actually put these in. Nope, can't do that. Well, one of them I can. I hope they increase bank space soon, too. Okay, let's go back. So first and foremost, Desolate Cavern seems achievable. Let's make some health packs and then let's go fight a boss. And then stop, because I think this is a decent stopping point. So we want bugs, herbs, and... Oh, geez. I cannot make a whole lot of HP kits. I apparently have not gathered a whole lot of... 6 HP kits. Is that enough? I have no idea. Alright, let's just drop these and go for it. I'll be fine. I mean, 32 HP. That should be easy enough to mess up Ugarok or whatever his name is. Yeah. Unless I start squandering that whatever remaining HP I have wastefully. Okay. I definitely don't need to do a lot of damage. Yeah, I never actually got to the last boss in Magicite. It was brutal. Alright, let's just keep summoning these guys. We need to fight a bunch of them. If we wanna be able to fight the boss. Weirdly enough, this is very similar to Vegante. Fight enough of his minions and he gets summoned. And I'd like to fight him in this general area, just because it gives me some room to maneuver. Also eyeballs. Though, I think at this point I need butterflies more than anything else. There we go. Okay. Kill you. I really wish I could make, like, health kits live. Just weird cow creature comes rolling in from up above. It's like, what are you doing here? And it's like, argh. Having a bad day, I see. Alright. Yep! Oograk has been summoned. Oh, crap. I've made mistakes here. I did not mean to summon so many dudes. Okay. That's fine. We still got 20 HP left. Come on, Oograk. You're not nearly as threatening as you look. I've also got plenty of mana, so I can stay zippity-doo-dah all day long. He's a lot harder to fight with a pistol, admittedly. Just because the pistol is single shot only. And takes a while to kill him. If you can get him good with a sword, you do way more damage. But, no dice. Alright, we've killed Oograk. This is not actually as hard as he looks. But maybe part of that is I'm fairly well geared at this point. I'm just gonna... Actually, you know what? I should probably get bugs. Because butterflies are... I'm low on those and I need more HP. So let's go back for a couple of the butterfly gatherings. There we go. And now that I've killed Oograk, I can actually kill as many worms as I want. Which I don't really care that much, but still. Okay, anything else down here? I mean, we got a rock. And a little bit of experience. I mean, the experience is nice. What level am I anyway? 10. Or 8. My bad. I wonder if level 10 is max. I have no idea. Alright. Well, I don't see any more beetles. So let's... We don't need herbs. We don't need much, really. Just beetles and eyeballs. Weird statement, that. But still. Okay. Should be... Ah, hello. You get out of my face. Out of my face. I want nothing to do with you. Do we have any more bugs? Nope. Well, let's go back. Let's go to the Desolate Canyon. He needs to spew poison globs all over. Not too much. That's what Dungeon Souls did, and it felt like ass. Felt like badass. It was not fun fighting the, it was not fighting that, what was it, second, third boss in Dungeon Souls in the original alpha version? That was rough. Man, that's a game that I'm waiting for it to patch before I play it again. Because it had some issues. And then they just went radio silent for like 2 months, and it's just like, well... Now what? Okay. So I don't wanna keep going. We've killed the only boss in the game. We're fairly well equipped with tier 1 equipment, actually. I might make it a mission of making, like, tier 2 or 3 equipment for the next episode. For now, though, I will see you guys next time. And as always, thanks for watching. I still need more drinks. I am thirsty.